Everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we are going to show you some of our garden upgrades. First, we'd like to show you how our seedlings are coming along. In that little greenhouse area right there, about a week ago, we planted tomatoes, several kinds of tomatoes, some butterfly bush.
Actually, let's open this up.
Okay. Now, this is one of our upgrades where Rick's added a second shelf to keep the seedlings right up next to the top, and we have this more expansive LED grow light full spectrum, but also has the red and blue pronounced spectrum in there. So we got butterfly bush, we have the tomatoes, I planted some giant strawberry seeds, and also that strawberry hydrangea seeds that you... All right, now I'm going to do this so maybe we can see better. I can tip it up a little bit. These are the French marigolds, and I wanted to get them started. They, of course, marigolds grow really nicely. These seeds were old, so... just because your seeds might be a couple years old doesn't mean they won't sprout. You may just have to do more of them because they probably won't all sprout, but you don't have to just... And then this, don't tell our daughter, but this is her little truck that has marigolds growing in it. Should be nice by Mother's Day, if indeed we can even see her on Mother's Day, but we'll hope so. Now, the nice thing about having this lower shelf, it also has grow lights underneath there. So as things get bigger, I can transplant them into different size pots, individual pots, or I can start another planting system. These are the bigger pots. These are the cow pods made out of cow manure. But I also have this kind of growing system as well. A little bit bigger than these little plugs that we put in the biodomes. So there's a variety of things you can get on the market, but now I have more space to do it. This was the LED light that I was talking about. This is a full spectrum, but it also has the red and the blue specifically as well.
Well, do you have any other... You want to see the succulents?
Yes, let's go look at those.
Okay.
Some of you may have seen when we planted our succulents. Actually, I should say we transplanted them into bigger pots, and some are individual plants now, and some are groupings. We also have upgraded in here. Now, instead of a table, we have a whole shelf arranged so that we have different levels for different things. And you may be wondering, well, what in the world is that?
Did you want to touch it?
No.
Why not?
Well, we now have a new little helper, Pepper, who is very curious about everything we're doing. And I remember in the past when we had our other standard poodle who loved also to look at everything, she would get into things. So in the olden days, we just used a mouse trap. And while she never got caught in it, thank goodness, we didn't let her do that, it scared her, so she would stay away from it. Well, they have now devised this new little trick where that whole big flap flaps down so it doesn't catch anybody, but it slaps down and will frighten her away so she knows, don't go there, that's not for you.
Well, I would say this definitely is an improvement from one tabletop.
Yes.
So
yes, it definitely
gives you more space.
Me more room, and...
Well, I'm waiting for some grow lights to come that I can hook up to the top of each of these main shelving. Right now, we just have some full-spectrum bulbs.
Right.
But that's fine.
They're working nicely.
I'd say they're doing really well.
Mm-hmm. As if we didn't have enough to do, we decided to experiment with a portable greenhouse that you can move to different places depending on what your location is, and grow things right using the sun as the as your heat source and your light. And it looked like kind of a fun thing, and as well it'll keep the rabbits off of my carrots if I plant carrots inside it. It's going to go right over one of our raised beds. Got this at Overstock, which is overstock.com, and it's about $40. So we'll see whether two college graduates can put it together or not.
In our living room.
Yeah, of course in our living room. Don't we build everything in our living room?
And for those who continually use the D word, then we should be able to grow vegetables right here on our carpet, right?
No.
Well, I mean, isn't that what the D word is all about?
No, it isn't.
You mean we're really going to plant food in soil?
Yes, and not on our carpet.
Oh, okay. Well, let's see how well you do in putting this together. I'll just sit there and watch.
Okay. Now, here's what I'm going to put together. Doesn't that look easy? Mm-hmm. The long ones and short ones.
You know, I feel a joke coming on.
Don't even go there.
I won't.
Well, this is how I'm going to start, with the base of it, obviously. So when we get it done, it's going to be 3 feet wide, 9 feet long, and 3 feet tall. So it looks kind of like Tinker Toys. Let me start at this corner here.
And what's nice about this is you can take it apart and store it for the winter.
Yes, you can. Fun. Piece of the bottom frame. There we are, all done.
Maybe this is where I'm going to keep you when you're naughty.
You may not like it. Okay. Now, just to give you a feel of how it will look once it's together, this is going to form the peak. Here. Doesn't it make sense now? We're kind of like making a little long barn.
Only three more to go.
Be like math online.
You mean this
geometry.
Could be a science project?
Geometry. Ooh, it's getting closer. I think I'm going to have to get out now.
Why?
I'm building myself in.
And the last piece.
Woohoo! And the last step was to put the plastic over the frame. Now, I remember in years past, Rick, you made us a greenhouse using PCV piping and PVC piping, and then we stretched material over it. This is a plastic net So it's very sturdy. And then to get to your plants, all you have to do is unzip the doors. And then you can just roll it up. And tie it up there. So that you can work inside. Or pull weeds or mulch or plant and eventually harvest.
So what are you going to start in here?
I'm going to start carrots in here and beets. And then I'm going to add some, when it gets a little bit warmer, I'll add some lettuce and something else. I don't know yet.
Well, that sounds like fun. So now you have two of these. So you have any idea where you're going to be putting them?
I'm putting them in the north garden.
Both of them?
I think so, because that's going to have the most sun over there. And we had tomatoes over there last year, so we can't have tomatoes over there this year.
Mm-hmm. Well, now the fun part begins, where you have to take it all apart.
Well, wish us luck. Here we go again. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you have questions or comments, we would love to hear from you. And we hope this is going to work out for us. If you'd like to become part of our garden family and see what happens, please hit that little subscribe button over here somewhere and become part of our garden family. Okay, it's your turn to take it down, Richard. I put it up.
Excuses, bye, excuses. See how hard she makes me work.
Connect with us on YouTube.